I am Dr. Swanlata Saraf, Professor, University Institute of Pharmacy, Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla University, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. Today we will know about the hair preparation, Module 1, Introduction to Human Hair Care Preparation, Module 2, Hair Coloring and Dyes, Module 3, Permanent Weaving, Module 4, Hair Straighteners, Module 5, Anti-Dandruff Preparations, Module 6, Conclusion. Module 1, Introduction to Human Hair Care Preparation. Let's start with general introduction about the human hair care preparation. Human hairs are composed of dead cells, which are mainly filled with on its moisture content. Human hair consists of approximately 65 to 95% keratin protein, and the remaining constituents are water, lipid, pigment, and trace elements. Proteins are made up of long chain of various mixtures of some 20 or 50 amino acids. Each chain takes up a helical or coiled form. Among numerous amino acids in human hair, cysteine is one of the most important amino acids. Hairs have a different function apart from the aesthetic of the person. In one hand, this is protection as it does on the scalp in relation to temperature. On the other hand, can be classified according to their structure and the amount of greasy that can drag on the hair leaving the skin, that is epidermis. According to their structure, hair are straight, wavy or curly, depending on the amount of grease that can accumulate normal, dry and oily hairs. As a protein, keratin has a property, the distortion that can affect hair in general when placed in contact with strong changes in temperature or pressure or in contact with chemicals, it can lose its structure and externally to the affected hair, alteration of elasticity, tear resistance. We should know about the skin because hair is a part of skin. Skin covers and protects our bodies. The skin at the forehead and scalp areas are of most interest when dealing with human hair, since most hair care products are developed specifically for head hair. The skin of the hand and fingers is also of importance because the feel of hair is often sensed by physically touching the fibers with such reasons. In general, skin is composed of three main parts: epidermis, dermis, and subcutaneous tissue. For many years, especially in the second half of the 20th century, scientists have focused on the physical and chemical properties of hair to consistently develop products which alter the health, feel, shine, color, softness, and overall aesthetics of hair. Hair care, everybody wants beautiful, healthy hair and skin. For most people, grooming and maintenance of hair and skin is a daily process. The demand for products that improve the look and feel of these surfaces has created a huge industry. Beauty care technology has advanced the cleaning, protection and restoration of desirable hair properties by altering the hair surface. Hair care products such as shampoos and conditioners and the maintenance and grooming process. Shampoos lean the hair and add feel, shine and softness. Mechanical process such as combining, cutting and blow drying serve to style the hair. Chemical products and process such as chemicals, dyes, colorant, bleaches and permanent wave treatment enhance the appearance and hue of the hair. Cosmetics preparation. Cosmetic is defined as an item intended to be rubbed, poured and introduced into the human body, thereof for cleansing, protecting, beautifying, promoting attractiveness. Hair care preparations are used for cleansing and conditioning treatment. These preparations are shampoo and conditioner. Shampoos are used primarily to clean the hair and scalp of dirt and other greasy residues that can build up after time. Shampoos also have many secondary functions, including controlling dandruff, reducing irritation, and even conditioning. Conditioners, on the other hand, are used primarily to give the hair a soft, smooth feel, which results in easier hair combing. Secondary functions include preventing flyaway hair due to static electricity, giving the hair a shining appearance, and protecting the hair from further damage by forming a thin coating over the fibers. Shampoo, the constitution and main function. In modern shampoo, advances in chemistry and technology have made it possible to replace the soap bases with complex formulas of cleansing agent, conditioning agent, functional additives, preservatives, aesthetic additives, and even medically active ingredients. Clarifying shampoo, typically used for full volume with lot of air between hair, is transparent. The pH value is typically 5 to 6. Cleansing agents. In most modern shampoos, the primary cleansing agent are anionic surfactant, which are known to be good in cleansing dirt, and greasy residues are removed from the hair and scalp by these surfactant, making them the most important part of the shampoo. Surfactants have great lathering capabilities and rinse off very easily. See table 1 for a full list of features. Table 1, components of common shampoos and their function. Shampoo consists of cleansing agent that produces lather to trap greasy matter and prevent. Conditioning agent, functional additives, preservatives, aesthetic additives, medicinally active ingredients. Now conditioner, its constitution and main function. Conditioner molecules contains cationic surfactants which give a positive electrical charge to the conditioner. The negative charge of the hair is attracted to the positively charged conditioner molecules, which results in conditioner deposition on the hair. Conditioner consists of a gel network, chassis, cationic surfactant, fatty alcohol and water for superior wet feel, and a combination of conditioning actives as cationic surfactant, fatty alcohol and silicones for superior dry feel. Module 2, hair coloring and dyeing. These are the agents which are used to change the natural color of the hair, either temporarily or permanently. Several plants were identified and used for coloring of hairs, eyebrows and eyelashes. Henna to obtain auburn tints. Lysimachia for imparting blood tint. Corrosion to dye the hair black. The important factor to be considered while selecting a dye are its molecular size and its pH. At high pH, hair may swell and absorption may be enhanced, but it may cause irreversible damage to hair. Most dyes are small molecules and thus penetrate hair easily. Hair coloring and dyeing have become extremely successful hair care procedures due to impart to over-the-counter style kits which allow home hair care without professional assistance. the most common dyes and para dyes, which contain paraphenylene diamine solutions accompanied by conditioners and antioxidants, hydrogen peroxide is combined with the para dyes to effectively create tinted insoluble molecules which are contained within the cortex and are not small enough to pass through the cuticle layers, leaving a desired color to the hair. Due to the level of hydrogen peroxide, severe chemical damage can ensue in the cuticle and cortex. The characteristics of colorants. An ideal hair colorant or dyes should have the following characteristics. It should color the hair without reducing natural gloss and without imparting its texture. It should not injure the hair and itself. It should be non-irritant and free from sensitizing action. It should not have systemic toxicity. Color of the dye's hair should be stable to physical factors like air, sunlight, friction and chemical factors like sweat. It should be stable in the formulation sold in the market. Depending on their effect as to how long it lasts, hair colorant may be divided into following categories: temporary hair colorant and semi-permanent hair colorant. Permanent hair colorant. Temporary hair colorant. The temporary dyes can be used for specific purposes such as adding colorful reflection, removing the yellowish effect of the white hair, and covering a small quantity of white hair. It allows the dyeing of hair containing up to 15% white hair due to their ability to deposit on the hair strands. These dyes that present acid characteristics usually have high molar mass. They contain anionic characteristics and are selected to allow the maximum solubility in water and the minimum penetration in hair. So it is removed in the first washing. They are presented as shampoo, gel, emulsion and solution with two different forms of application. Continuous application, that is progressive, or single application with one wash at the end of the application process to remove the unabsorbed dye excess on the hair. Semi-permanent hair colorant. These formulations contain basic or cationic dyes with low molar mass, which has a high affinity for hair keratin and resist from 3 to 6 washes. The hair dyeing process does not involve oxidation reaction. The application is simple and lasts from 10 to 40 minutes followed by rinsing. Several products are available in the market: lotions, shampoos, mousses and emulsions. These cosmetic forms must have the ideal viscosity so that they do not flow during the application. Dyes with low molar mass penetrate slightly in the cortex, especially because of the high pH value of the product that promotes the cuticle opening. The good performance of semi-permanent dyes is directly related to their great water solubility. In general, the nitroanilines are not soluble in water and require a glycol or glycol derivatives such as glycerin to be solubilized in the formulation. Specific solvents such as mixtures of quaternary salts of high molecular weight such as quaternium 80, benzyl alcohol and glycols are used to ensure not only their solubility in the formulation but also during application and product storage. Permanent hair colorants. The permanent hair dyes are commonly used because this category provides greater efficacy of permanent dyeing, resistance to shampoo, washes and other external factors such as drying, friction, light and others. This category represents about 80% of the sold hair dyes and gets an initiate covering up to 100% of white hair strands. Also, it is possible to have dark and light natural hair colors due to the combination of the oxidizing agents with the ammonia hydroxide. The reaction occurs in an alkaline medium that promotes the opening of the cuticle that allows the penetration of the dyes molecules into the cortex. The oxidizing agent permits the beginning of the reaction that occurs in the cortex and results in a colorful complex with high molar mass, which avoids the exit of molecules formed in the hair. Part of the reaction also happens on the cuticles and the molecules are removed in the first process. The ammonia hydroxide and ethanolamine are the most alkalizing agent used. The mixture of surfactant and solvents is used to disperse the dye molecules and ensures the hair wetting. A small amount of reducing agent is added to prevent auto-oxidation of the dyes during storage of the finished product, which may be formulated as an emulsion, gel solution and powder. The reactions involved in the formation of permanent dyes are redox type and requires four major components. The aromatic amine with substitution at positions ortho or para, hydroxy or amino as the coupling basis, the reaction modifier and alkylating compounds and an oxidizing agent. Module 3. Permanent hair weaving preparations. These are the preparations which provide the curly or wavy hair. Either it may be normal or straight. As always, the curling hair is more attractive than straight hair and also can be arranged in further attractive styles. There are various methods and preparations which are used to achieve waving a hair, that is wave set preparations, hot wave preparations, cold wave preparations, etc. Every method possesses different manner for waving or curling of hair. Permanent wave treatments saw many advances in the beginning of the 20th century but have not changed much with the invention of the cold wave around the turn of that century. Generally speaking, the cold wave uses mercaptans, typically thioglycolic acid, to break down disulfide bridges and style the hair without much user interaction, at least in the period soon after the perm application. The cold wave process does not need increased temperature, so no thermal damage to the hair, but generally consists of a reduction period. During reduction period, molecular reorientation to the cuticle and cortex occurs via disulfide mercaptan interchange pathway, followed by rinsing, setting of the hair to the desired style, and finally neutralization to decrease the mercaptan levels and stabilize the style. The chemical damage brought on by the permanent wave can increase dramatically when not performed with care. Methods and preparation of waving. Cold waving preparation, hot waving preparation, wave set preparation. Cold waving preparations. In cold waving preparations, external heel is not applied to the hair. The process is performed at room temperature. Cold waving can be achieved by different methods. A. Chemical neutralization. B. Atmospheric oxidation. C. Special methods like using pin pump, roller pump, etc. The process of waving of hair is first cleansing the hair to remove greasy and dust. Whole hair is divided into parts and waving lotion is applied thoroughly and wound on curler. Kept on about 20 to 40 minutes. Then the hair is rinsing with neutralizer and kept for 10 minutes. Hair is removed from the hair curler and once again washed with neutralizing solution. Then finally the hair is rinsed off. Module 4, hair straighteners. As we found, the persons who have curly hair want straight hair and the persons who have straight hair want to have curly hair. This led to the need for formulation of the hair straighteners. Though the hair straighteners are action wise opposite to waving on curling process, but it is discussed here as this is also achieved by modifying the hair structure by breaking cross linkages. There are different methods or techniques for straightening of hairs. Hot comb pressing oil method. In this method, first petroleum jelly is applied to straighten the hair and then combed using a hot metal. A mixture of petroleum and paraffin can also be used. Petroleum acts as a heat transfer agent between hot metal and hair. After doing the hot comb, the hair is washed and dried. The method is not a permanent one. In caustic preparation, in this method, caustic alkali preparation is cream form are applied for straightening purpose. The alkali is used in between 4.9% and higher concentration makes the process faster. To prepare the cream, selection of oil phase and surfactants has to be done carefully. They should not form salt with alkali. As alkali causes damage to scalp or eyes, care should be taken. Chemical hair reducing agent, thioglycolate reducing agents can be used also as they break disulfide linkages of a curly hair and straighten them. The curlers are removed after thioglycolate treatment when the hair is in soft condition. Then the hair is rinsed with neutralizing lotion. After this, a suitable cream is applied to hold the hair firmly in position. Module 5, Anti-dandruff preparations. Dandruff is the shedding of dead skin cells from the scalp. Dandruff is a common scalp disorder affecting almost half of the population at the post-pubertal age and of any gender and ethnicity. It often causes itching. It has been well established that keratinocytes play a key role in expression and generation of immunological reactions during dandruff formation. Dandruff can be several causes, including dry skin, seborrheic dermatitis, not cleaning, scrubbing often enough, shampooing too often, psoriasis, eczema, sensitivity to hair care products, or a yeast-like fungus. Dry skin is the most common cause of flaking dandruff. Anti-dandruff shampoos. Anti-dandruff agents are incorporated to prevent microbial infection of a scalp and to treat dandruff respectively. Materials used in the treatment of dandruff are thymol 0.05 to 0.2%, bithionol 0.5 to 1%, pyrithione zinc up to 2%, resorcinol 0.05 to 1%, selenium sulfide 1 to 2.5%, prepared coal tar 2 2 to 2.5%, quaternary ammonium compounds 1.5 to 2%. Evaluation of anti-dandruff shampoos. Appearance. The appearance of the prepared shampoos was visually observed in a black and white background. Viscosity. The viscosity of prepared anti-dandruff shampoo was determined by viscometer. The pH testing were performed by using the standard pH paper. Foaming property by using cylinder shake method, the foam test determined. The procedure of foam test is 50 ml of the 1% shampoo solution was put into 500 ml graduated cylinder, then it is covered with hand, then it is shaken 12 times. The total volume of the foam content after 1 minute were recorded. Foam volume was calculated after shaking the volume of the foam at 1 minute interval for 4 minutes were recorded. That height of the foam reaches at level of 150 ml is best acceptable shampoo. Anti-dandruff shampoo can be grouped according to its content. Pyrethrum zinc shampoo contains zinc pyrethrum, which is antibacterial and antifungal agent, can reduce the fungus on the scalp that causes dandruff and seborrheic dermatitis. Tar-based shampoo is a result of the coal manufacturing process, can help to overcome dandruff, seborrheic dermatitis and psoriasis by slowing cell death and exfoliation of skin heads. Shampoo containing salicylic acid helps remove the layer of this type of dandruff but can cause the scalp become dry. Use conditioner after shampooing to reduce dryness in the scalp. Selenium sulfide shampoo work by slowing skin cell death and to reduce the fungus melasses. This type of shampoo can fade colored hair, so be sure to use it as directed and rinse well after shampooing. Module 6, Conclusion. The main objective of our study to explain simple process of how to hair care preparations and daily habit to take care of it. Among the various options of hair colorant and dyes, it is interesting to know the application features and their affinity for best option for each hair types and to provide a satisfactory effect as a good covering power of gray, white hair, good color resistance to shampoo, washes, and high durability of color. The challenges is to find options that provide security in the application and allow these benefits to occur without generating very aggressive damage to the hair strands. The right type of hair color for the looks you want and for your specific hair can result in a beautiful new you. Understanding the differences and utilizing a professional colorist are ways to get picture perfect results. So student, study hard and enhance your knowledge. Hope you enjoyed this interaction about the hair preparation. All the best. This is Dr. Sarlata Saraf signing off. If you want to learn more and enhance your knowledge, you may log on to our website for MCQ, quizzes, LORs. Our website is www.cec.nic.in. Till then, keep studying. Goodbye.